Good morning, class. I hope you all are good at your home and healthy. So, in our first class, as you know that our first interaction didn't happen. So, for this inconvenience, we are very sorry and very apologize for it. But with the best hopes, with the best wishes, let's start the first class with the chapter number 1 of the book, It So Happened. The chapter number 1 is How the Camel Got His Hump. As you all know that the camel has a biological structure in which it appears with a big and strong structure of hump on its back. So, it is the story of a camel. Why did he got hump? It means it is telling you the story of the ancient times when the camels were not having the hump. And this story is totally fictional. Don't take it seriously and don't take it as the biological reason of the camel getting hump. Okay, so the chapter is about, and its preface is following, that the world had just begun and the animals were working for humans. There was one lazy animal that did nothing and said nothing but hump. Even the clever dudgeon was at its wit's end. So, this is the story of a lazy camel. As you understand by this preface, there was a camel who was very lazy and he always said hum and he did nothing. He was very lazy. That's why he always denied the work, refused the work to do. Whoever says to him to work, whoever asks him to do the work, he always replied them by the word humph. Okay, so at the first statement, let's move on to the first statement. In the beginning, when the world was new and the animals were just beginning to work for man, there was a camel and he lived in the middle of the howling desert. Howling desert, it means it is name of the desert where the camel was living. Actually, the name is not mentioned of the camel name is not mentioned. It's just written camel. So he was living in the howling desert, but he did not want to work because he was lazy, as you all know. So he ate sticks, thorns and prickles. You all know that the camels are the sheep of the desert. They are called the sheep of the desert because they are the only animals who can adapt themselves and survive in that extreme situation of climate. So they are adapted and they are meant to live in that kind of situation. So you can understand that the camel was living in the desert from the ancient times, but that time he was not having any hump. You can see in the picture also that there is a dog who is holding a stick in his mouth and the camel is eating some green grasses. I hope it is not a grass, actually it is shrub. Okay, so he ate sticks, thorns and prickles, and when anybody spoke to him, he says hum. It means if anybody comes to him and says or asks to do any work, he always gives a single reply that hum. It means he always denies. Presently, the horse came to him on Monday morning with a saddle on his back and said, "Camel, oh camel, come out and trot like the rest of us." "Humph," said the camel, and the horse went away and told the man. It means The man who was the owner of the animals and who was taming all other animals, other animals like the horse, was working and he was carrying the loads on his back. And he also asked camel to take some load on his back, but he denied to work. Okay, and what he said, he replied with hum. And the horse went away. So the horse was nothing to do. He just listened the answer. He listened the reply of the camel and he didn't bother about it and he went away. But he told about the reply of the camel to the man who was the owner and who was the master of all the animals. As you know that it is already written at the beginning of the chapter that the man was the master of all the animals. Okay. Presently the dog came to him with a stick in his mouth and said, "Camel, oh camel, come and fetch and carry like the rest of us." It means a horse, dog is also carrying some stuff. And he also asked the camel and he advised to take some load on his back. "Humph," said the camel, and the dog went away and told the man. Now the dog was also denied by the camel that he is not going to do any work. Presently the ox came to him, wired the yoke on his neck and said, "Camel, oh camel, come and plow like rest of us." So the ox was plowing the field and asked the camel to do the plowing with him and come along. But the camel was slopping his food and he was totally busy taking rest. So when the ox reached to the man, he also talked about the laziness of the camel to the man. Now at the end of the day, the man called the horse and the dog and the ox together and said, three, I am very sorry for you, but the humph thing is the desert can't work, or he would have been there by now. So I am going to leave him alone and you must work double time to make up for me." It means now the man decided that because the camel is not working for him, so he didn't bother to make him to do the work. So he decided that it's simply to say and ask the other animals to buck up. It means to support the cover or to cover up the all work by others by making them to work their double. Okay, so they made them to work double time. Okay, then that made the three very angry and they held a panchayat on the edge of the desert. And the camel came chewing cud and laughed at them. Then he said, "Humph," and went away again. So they called all the animals. They talked to each other. Camel also participated in that panchayat. But he didn't give any reply. And he was laughing on other who were working and they were diligent, but he is not working and he was taking its totally advantage because he was not asked to do anything by the man, because man was knowing that if he has already three servants, why he would say and why he would take any effort to do other animal to do the work. Okay, so he just decided and he put all the loads to the other animals so that he must not have taken any effort. Okay, so presently there came along the Dudden, who was in charge of all deserts, rolling in the cloud of dust. So the dozen was a person who was very talented and he was the in charge of all the deserts. So all of them who were the victim of the workload, they came to dozen to solve their problem. Okay. The dozen was a jinn. He was a jinn and who had some magical powers. Dozen of all deserts, said the horse. It is right for anyone to be idle?
Certainly not, said the dozen.
So, dozen asked them the what are their problems. So, dozen of all desert. So, the horse told his problem that is it right for anyone to be idle? It means, is it good that if somebody is lazy, that others should work for him? Dozen said, no, certainly not. Well, this said the horse, there is a thing in the middle of your desert with a long neck and long legs and he has not done a stroke of work since Monday morning and he won't trot. It means he is not doing anything and he has a good body and he is perfectly okay to do the work, but in spite of having a good body, a good structure, he is not doing a bit and he is becoming idle, and because of his idleness we are working double. Okay, so now Dozen has listened to the problem of horse. And he was a little understood about the problem of the horse. Then, phew, said the dozen whistling, that's my camel. What does he say about? Now, dozen understood that who was that animal. Now he understood that he was camel. And he is not wishing to do any work. He says, hump. And he won't plow, said the ox. Now the complaint of the ox came. Ox also has the same complaint about the camel, that he always replies with humph.
Very good, said the dozen. I will humph him if you will kindly wait a minute.
Okay, now Dozen has decided and he made up his mind to do something very interesting with the camel, and now the camel will not understand his mistake according to Dozen. So, after this, we will see in the next class about the second paragraph. I hope you all have enjoyed this chapter till now. Okay, in the next class, we will understand the half of the chapter, and I hope you would be healthy and safe. Thank you, everyone.